let's all do it together. Chord, and what fingers are we using? Little finger, middle finger, thumb. Now everybody switch to your right hand.
Hi, my name is Kylie Ibarra. I'm the principal at Frank Augustus Miller Middle School. We are the newest middle school here in Riverside Unified. We just opened in August of 2009, so we are currently in our inaugural year. One of the decisions that we made at Frank Augustus Miller was to open this piano lab. Historically, in Riverside Unified, you've had what's called a seventh grade wheel. And on that wheel, your children are supposed to get, it's kind of, I've always described it as a big pie, and they get three slices of a pie throughout the year. And it's historically been music appreciation, a foreign language, and a technology class. But some of my past experiences at middle schools, what I found is that the music appreciation class hasn't always been the most popular. The buy-in isn't always there. So when I had the opportunity to hire Paul Salyers, the band director from Ramona High School, one of the things I talked to him about was this seventh grade music appreciation class and changing it, making it something different. And he came with the idea of doing a piano lab.
My name is Paul Salyers. I am the music person here. I teach two periods of band, two piano classes, and choir. I do it all. I'm the performing arts.
I've been having you play just a melody line so far up to this date. Well, now we've worked to a point where we need to be able to identify a chord and how to do it with the correct fingerings.
We got in contact with Yamaha, and they sent me out to Virginia to train on how to teach using this system. Sent us all the pianos, and there it is. I can teach from a software program, or I can just teach piano.
Everybody, left hand. Together, ready, one, two, ready, go.
Our piano lab is actually made up of 18 units, and they're electrical keyboards, and there's two students per unit.
Put your headphones on. Speakers on.
They have their own individual mini electronical keyboard on each one. They wear earphones, so everything in here is, they're not bothering the person next to them. Those kids who know nothing, nobody next to them knows that they don't know.
I can listen to them by use of the headphones. I'm able to communicate. I can tell them when and what to do, take your headphones off, listen to this song. Whatever I play up at my station, they can hear. I can ask individuals to hit their speakers, or I can actually turn them on manually and hear them play, and the rest of the class can't.
America.
Music right now in today's economic situation is being cut. And for us, the first thing that goes in some of our families is those extracurricular music lessons.
Music education is important. It's important in every school. There's a side of a lot of students, that the creative side, that we can't let go of. We've got to take that creativity and let them bloom into somebody. And I mean, can you imagine movies without music? That's what happens when you cut out music in the lower grades. It's just going to go away, and we don't want to see that happen.
Second row, one, two.
My name is Angel Ohms, and I'm in seventh grade. I really enjoy the class, and I felt that I had more to learn here than I did going to my next class, so I chose to stay in here two trimesters.
The engagement is 100%. I have kids, eighth graders, who are being very sneaky trying to get into this class.
I was actually thinking about taking up trumpet. I was thinking about, yeah. And I thought that would be pretty cool, because I was always a big fan of Dizzy Gillespie, world's famous trumpet players.
And you're a seventh grader?
Yes.
So you want to be in band next year?
Yeah.
See, that's what this class is.
It was something that financially was not out of means. It was within means. It was very reasonable, and if I could do it all again, I would do even a second lab. It's finding that teacher who is willing to step out of the box and be able to work within the world of technology and music combined.
And we have a jazz band now here at this school that meets seventh period.
It's that next level. It's that next where we're going in the year 2010.
10 years down the road, and take all the musical knowledge they got here, and I bet you half of them will be playing piano in their own homes, teaching their own kids how to play.
I'm Midshipman First Class Howser from the United States Naval Academy. This is here at my alma mater at Corona High School, where I graduated in 2006. During my time here, I participated in both varsity baseball and soccer, as well as the ASB program. I was able to stay focused enough to graduate at the top of my class, valedictorian, 06, here at Corona High. I am a senior midshipman at the Naval Academy, and I recently found out that I'm getting my service selection that I put in for, which is Marine Corps pilot. I can look forward to graduating in May, attending the basic school in Quantico, Virginia for several months, and then heading down to Pensacola, Florida for several months to a couple years to get my flight wings, and then it's off to where the military needs me. Got interested in the Naval Academy through my family. I had three cousins that graduated from there, so that's where I was dead set on going. The Naval Academy is a very competitive place to get into, as are all the service academies, and what I did pretty much to get in was a complete life change that set me on the course to do what I wanted to do and get to where I wanted to get. That involved good grades, being physically fit, active in the community, staying focused whenever it came time to make decisions. Make sure you make the right decisions, and it actually comes down to, you know, how focused and disciplined you are to obtain things that you want in life. The 44th District of California is Congressman Ken Calvert, who I got in contact with in his office, and through coordination with them and some different meetings and lectures that you'll go to, your name gets put into the system, registering that you're interested in attending one of the service academies. Applications to most schools are pretty involved, but I would suggest that if you are serious about going to one of the academies, you get started on them as soon as you can. It's a pretty thick packet. Here in California, in the 44th District, you're also gonna have to participate in an interview with senior ranking officers and those that have been there and done that before, so that they can get a feel for you. Life as a midshipman is difficult, as one would assume. The average day consists of you getting up at 6:30, going to several formations a day, and participating in the rigors of the academics of a top-ranked engineering program in the country. You have to be involved in some kind of physical activity. Now, that could be anywhere from a varsity to a club to an ECA sport, but if you're not involved in any one of these, intramurals is something that you definitely have to participate in. If you're only focused on academics or the physical mission that the United States Naval Academy presents, you might want to rethink some things. While it is a completely paid for tuition that you'll be getting over your 4 years there, you do have a 5-year commitment when it's all said and done. One of the greatest things is the selfless duty to serve one's country. It really comes down to, if you want to be successful there, understand what you're getting yourself into, contact who you need to contact to make sure you have the questions that you have answered properly, and get your mindset ready that you're gonna be in for some work. It is gonna be a struggle. There's gonna be a lot of intensity. You just wake up every day excited about what you're doing, going to work, and pretty much live every day till it's fullest, and you get used to it and things work out.
In Alvord Unified School District, Norte Vista High School is on track this year to graduate its first crop of seniors from its fledgling International Baccalaureate program. 26 will graduate as IB diploma candidates and another 50 with IB certificates. At it's a growing program.
I'm Grace Amos.
I'm Lily Lozada.
I'm Kelsey Milhorn.
And I'm Dallas Holt.
Grace Amos is our past president for IB. I'm going to pass over the mic so she can tell us a little bit more about it.
Yeah, IB is a program where it's short for International Baccalaureate. It's where our students aim for a higher standard by doing international level classes. It's a really global thing, and that's why the International Club is so involved. We want to promote global learning and being part of the bigger world, not just our school community.
Sean Marshall, Norte Vista's IB coordinator, and Alisa Martinez, working with the International Club students, are finding creative ways to energize the young program. Here's a look at one event from this school year, an International Day on campus. The event gave students a social opportunity to unwind after a morning spent with a PSAT test, and it helped them explore the broader world around them. The focus this day was on Scandinavia. Community members also participated in the event, including members of the Riverside chapter of VASA, an organization founded in the 1800s to help Scandinavian immigrants to America. Here's a look at the day.
Jag ska berätta om Vasa för dig. Att där kan vi komma och prata skandinaviska språk.
Our international club has about 40 members, and what we do is 1 week every student comes in and reports about an issue around the world. Once a semester, we put on a big assembly. Our first assembly was the Mexican Fiesta. We started with home. Our school is primarily Hispanic. It's 87%. Once we learned about ourselves, then we started to venture out.
We want to really encourage our students to go places, to dream things, and to achieve what they never thought they could.
Congratulations, Norte Vista.
Manifesto of the editors of the Encyclopedia to overturn the barriers that reason never erected reflects the goals of the intellectual movement known as A, Catholicism, B, Enlightenment, C, Romanticism, D, Scholasticism, or E, Conservatism. B, Enlightenment.
Yeah.
Correct answer is C, philosophe. B, privileged elites and exploited lower members. Correct answer A, Montesquieu. All right, honors scholars, please sign your score sheets, make sure they're correct and sign your score sheets and return to your teams. Proctors, please complete your tabulations and return all your materials to the envelope.
Welcome to the 27th Annual Riverside County Academic Decathlon Awards presentation. And the 2010 Riverside County Academic Decathlon first place team with a total score of 41,798.4 goes to West Valley High School. And we will present the winning coach with the plaque, Billy Valenzuela. Coaches, I do have your plaques available if you want to come to pick them up.
Feels great. We got great schools at Hemet Unified, and it took everyone from the principal down to the janitors. Everyone helped us get this victory, but especially our team MVP, Kaylee, the highest scoring student in Riverside County.
We studied for 9 months, and for the last couple of weeks, we were staying 13 hours a day to study. And I think our team really deserved it, but I didn't expect this. I'm being honest right now.
All right.
This is not about superintendent at all. I'm just along for the ride. This is really about dedicated staff members and tremendously smart and hardworking students. And I couldn't be more proud of these kids. And I know that they're really going to represent us well up in Sacramento. So, whew, go Mustangs!
And once again, for the 12th year in a row, the superintendent of the Riverside County champion. And the first and second place teams as well, both in Hemet Unified.
I came across a catalog advertising ROP programs, and the sports medicine program that Jim Clover was teaching jumped out at me. I ended up taking it, and that pretty much influenced my career. Sports medicine was extremely interesting, and I ended up getting a job at RCC and worked there for almost 12 years before I joined the military. My main interest was aviation, it always had been. Just at 30 years old, I joined the Air National Guard, and that's where I'm at now.
You think of the people that you run into, that they have one profession and one profession only. Well, she has two. She's an amazing person.
Jim Clover's class influenced me joining the military also, because it definitely prepared me for a male-oriented environment or male-dominated environment.
She's the one that I think ought to be today's heroes, Terri Torres, as compared to all these other sports heroes that always go down the tube. This is the one that grabbed on her bootstraps and she made it. She's an incredible young lady.
One by one, New Orleans' weakest and sickest are being loaded onto the C-130 behind me. They're using borrowed baggage cars to do that. Now, this isn't continental, but this trip will get them to their destination, and that's prompt medical attention.
Throughout high school, many times someone had told me, you can't do that, that's beyond your reach, and never listen to any kind of advice like that, because if I had, I wouldn't be where I'm at. You definitely have to just keep plugging away and follow your dreams.